Professor Fuchido for his presentation. And now I open the discussion if there are questions or comments.
Please, slowly.
As Italians, we have sometimes problems in understanding people talking too fast. So please.
Thank you so much. I think this is brilliant. And it shows both in theory and in the cases you cite why reframing strategies can avoid a clash of sovereignties. So this is a wonderful, right? So this is great.
Maybe Gilad can answer.
Is it for? But I have a question about the posture of your argument, because I wasn't sure whether you were in some way universalizing your position, or are we somehow committed to a comparative cultural perspective, in which case we have no authority, for example, to tell a French society that laissez-faire is not as good, you know, as avoiding the clash. So what is your position in terms of the prescriptive quality of the club?
Thank you for this question. I was waiting for it, because before I write something when my colleague was talking before, speaking before. I think that there is now in Europe not a clashing power. They don't talk about sovereignty, because the idea of sovereignty that born everybody knows in Uccio da Pisa. Uccio da Pisa written that rex superiore non recognoscens, il regno suo est imperator. So that idea of sovereignty now is not good for religion, communities, and states. I think that now there is in course an osmotic process. Religious values go inside the norms, not in a political way like before, but by the choosing of the faithful. So more faithful you have, more people choosing some legal instruments that are really suggested from your faith. For example, in Italy, you know, we have the Holy See in Italy. So the problem political is very, very big. All political action transit between nearly the Vatican State. And we use the Concordato, you know, is a contract from state and church to like a deal about some arguments. But now, no one talking about a new deal, a new Concordato. No one. Because it's impossible in our society, this society, talk about deal with church or with other faiths. They clashing in the political view. So they use other systems now. That I think that these systems must be improved. This is my idea. Because if you are Muslim or Jewish or Catholic, you have the right to live about your choices.
May I push back just a little bit? If osmosis is a cultural process, and if that process is not taking place, then you have a clash of sovereignty from your position imposing what's best, or how best to define the meaning of the individual's belief within a particular state. Do you know what I mean?
Yes, I understand. For me, if it is not a criminal offense, everything you can do.
Yes, I wanted to probe you a little bit more because you seem to come to the conclusion that having more religious laws incorporated and enforced by the state is a good thing. It's religious freedom. But where the problems can arise is the conflict between individual and group freedoms. And if we have a mandatory system of religious law, that's not something that somebody agrees to submit to voluntary arbitration, then arguably for the individual, it's a limitation on freedom. So there's a famous case in India, the Shah Bano case, are you familiar, 1985, where this happened, because there are such separate civil codes for different religious communities in India. And just for those of you who don't know, the woman who was divorced by her husband at the age of 62 was given no financial support. So the Indian court said this is an atrocity and granted her support. Then there was a hue and cry from the community, the religious community, and the parliament overturned what the court had said. Then it was subsequently where it doesn't matter what the posture is, the facts are sufficiently clear. We can't just say that more religious laws means more religious freedom, can we? We also have to look at these conflicts between the group and the individual and whether these laws are binding or whether they are voluntarily submitted to an arbitration. So how would you adjudicate those kinds of conflicts?
In Italy, we have an important case about Jehovah's Witness. The Jehovah's Witness respond inside their community, and when they do an offense to their rules, they are put it out by the communities. And they went to the civil tribunal to ask to the civil tribunal, please, I would go back to my community. And the civil tribunal say, it's not my matter. So in Italy we have a system, political system, that in the Bill of Rights, Article 8, there is a reserve to the special deals from the state for with every confessions. Every religious communities. So the way to choose is not own rules, not own rules, but of course the rules are their source inside the religious communities, because otherwise we'd be anarchy. Everybody have their own good. If you believe in something and you approaching to a community, in fact, you can respect your rules. But all the rules must move inside a legal system, inside the legal system. But there are the matters that are strictly reserved to the power of the state, of course. But in many matters, I think that this cultural framework can work.
I agree with your social cultural interpretation of the relationship between law and religion, which has to take into consideration history, so of course religion is and law as osmotic one another. Then you mentioned the opinion by Lord Phillips in England before there was the speech by the Archbishop of Canterbury that Sharia law is applied. Probably you did not mention that this has caused lots of criticism, both against the Archbishop and Lord Williams. And with regard to your definition of religious courts and as an example of religious freedom, which can be agreeable, my point is, what about when in a direct or indirect way, a decision made by a religious arbitrator is against the state law? I mean, you mentioned the case of Muslim Sharia councils, and they exist in England, they are accepted in England with some favors, but there are lots of Muslim feminists acting today against this tribunal because they are considered to be an instrument to maintain that sort of gender gap. And so in the end, if one of these supporter of human rights could ask you, would you prefer the religious freedom of the Sharia Council or the right of the woman to be a free individual? I mean, I see probably you are to be too much optimistic.
I expect every time a personal choice.
Well, so it's not a personal choice. The problem is that it is exactly...
Sometimes it is.
It is
sometimes
not
is.
The choice of the woman sometimes. It is the community imposing that solution.
If the community
according
impose,
to this, according to this,
yes,
to this approach.
Yes, if the community, my idea is moving inside of a legal system where the principle of freedom, all the freedoms, all the rights of a person are not in discussion. Okay, so...
Well, this is a theory.
So,
this is not the reality.
It's not a theory. Because, for example, in some countries like mine and yours, this is the way is correct that we are going over. I think that not the arbitration happily compulsory religious rules. I think that there must be a choice. If you choose to go in front of arbitration, religious arbitration court, it's your choice. You know that in Italy, in our system, now this is impossible to do it. It's impossible. Because in the new law on arbitration, la mediazione, there is no space for arbitration courts now. But my opinion is that you can repeat what you said. Okay. For the context of the of your choice about your cultural idea, and cultural is based on religious opinion. For example, two children are fed for a ball, and one child tells to the other, ball is mine. They have just 7 years old. Why little child know that ball is okay. So, what's meaning? That in all the norms, there is sometimes something, some concept that the norms don't say. It is the limit of civil law system. In civil law system, we have the norms, but the context of the norm is a cultural context.
Yes, of course, I agree. My point is that there is no free choice. Free choice as an act of an individual many times to choose a Sharia council. It is a choice which derives indirectly from some sort of social pressure. Because a Pakistani girl,
of course.
In Italy, Jehovah's Witness. No, okay. I don't want to go to come back to Italy. I'm saying that in the situation of local Muslim communities in England, the opening of Muslim Sharia Council is a very controversial topic. So it is not seen as a step forward for religious freedom, but it's a step back.
You can active all the other legal
Yeah, but the point of the gender gap with the introduction of the Muslim culture being discussed in Canada in the Education Act and the government has...
I'm just saying that it is not that easy. It's not that easy to say it's food.
These are competing ideals of freedom.
Yeah, there is a risk.
So you have forum shopping. Based upon whether strategically your theory of freedom is optimized.
Forum shopping is enough.
Sorry, I think we have to close our interesting discussion.